One more.
Oh man, that took carry on.
Today I'm gonna reveal the truth about some of the biggest fishing myths.
To never bring bananas onto a fishing boat. Many friends of mine have told me that if you bring a banana onto a fishing boat, the fish will not bite. There is actually no scientific proof that says this is true. It probably came from the age-old belief that when you bring bananas onto a long sea voyage, the ethylene from bananas would actually cause other fruits and vegetables to rot prematurely, causing the crew to starve. In reality, bananas are a great source of vitamins, potassium, and carbohydrates, and make a great snack for going outdoors because of its biodegradable packaging. But then again, what is life without a little bit of superstition? They say loud noises scare away fish. Well, that's not always true. The thing is, when noise travels from air to water, it usually just spreads around and scatters, like ping pong balls bouncing on a tiled floor. However, if you do make loud noises by stomping your feet on the boat or the ground, the vibrations from the solids will actually travel through the water and definitely spooking the fish. Some people say fish bite better when it rains. Well, that's not 100% true. When you think about it, there are many types of rain. Take, for example, when you see rain, it's a change in pH levels, and barometric pressure change, and many other factors. So as good fishermen, you cannot just assume that just because it's raining, the fish are biting. You have to consider other factors before you make your calculation. Fish prefer red-colored hooks. Now, the idea goes that if you have red hooks on your lure, it would make it look like an injured animal with blood coming out of it, thus attracting the attention of bigger predator fish. If you look at the signs of it, after 3 meters, red actually becomes a more grayish green color, so the color doesn't really matter. Should this theory be true, it only works from 0 to 3 meters anyway. If you want to catch big fish, you have to use big baits. That is not always true. Some species, like the Siamese giant carp, which can grow up to 300 kilograms, eat nothing but vegetables and small insects their whole lives. So, why big baits? You can use big baits for predator species if you're trying to avoid catching the smaller versions of them. That way you can focus all your time on catching the big ones. Oh man, that took coffee note. Now let's put away the lies and hook us a real one. Fish on! Ooh. It's a platon. Striped snakehead, not too big. Ooh, it's... Here we go. So there you go, guys. Don't believe everything you hear. Do your own research. Consider all the factors before drawing any conclusions, and then you'll get your fish. It's time to let this little guy go. Hey, watch. Watch, watch.
What up, dude? What up, dude? What up, dude? What up, dude?
I'm like, now I'm enjoying it.
Namaste. I am Yoki Oz. Yoga is an ancient art that probably came from somewhere in Asia. But either way, now it's so popular with all the trendy people that I too had to get into it to strengthen my body and my mind.
But I've heard about a new kind of yoga that pushes the limits even further, and you could do it while fishing.
Today, I'm gonna learn how to use a stand-up paddleboard and see if I could use that to fish.
But first, I need to work on my balance.
2 left leg down. ยกขาโอเคเลยขาสุดท้ายของซับโยคะเนี่ยคือสวาสนะนะคะก็นอนเลย
I'm gonna need 20 minutes to do this last pose. Good night.
Enough of this trendy stuff. I want to see if I can fish on this.
มีปลาอะไรบ้างครับ
ขอให้นอนเยอะๆครับ I'm feeling pretty confident about my paddling skills right now. I reckon I could probably fish and not fall in the water. I'll try at least. And this looks like a good spot to start. I snagged my lure onto a hyacinth. It's all good.
Fish on!
That's an archer fish. What the heck? Oh, so cool. I've never caught an archer fish in my life. Okay, so really interesting species of fish. The archer fish gets its name from the fact that it shoots water up into the air to hit bugs to fall down into water and into his mouth. It's such a cute fish. Hop, hop, hop. Mwah.
Bye.
We are now approaching a Thai riverside temple.
The crazy cool thing is, devotees feed the fish, so thousands of them swarm here for a free meal.
Hey, watch. Watch, watch. I'm just gonna put a bunch of food here, and eventually the big catfish will show up. When you do come in, look, you can actually pat them on the head, and they're totally cool with this. See? What up, dude? What up, dude? What up, dude? What up, dude?
Hey, gang, what's up?
Oh, nom, 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 nom. Loud noises scare them, too. So try not to make om nom nom too loud.
Om nom nom nom. Om nom nom nom.
I just spotted these two dudes fishing in the canal. So I'm going to join them.
ตกปลาอะไรกันครับผม
ปลากระแหครับ
แล้วพี่จะเอาไปทำอะไรปลาตัวนี
้เอาไปตากแดดแดดหนึ่งแล้วก็จะทอดกรอบ
This is what the traditional fishing looks like. You're sitting there, you got a bait, put in the water, and just wait for fish to come up. Oh,
fish on! Yeah, ได้ปลาแล้ว Yeah, fish on!
ดีเยี่ยมเลย
Oh man, canal bait fishing.
เก่งมากเลย
I think this segment's all about the cute-sized fish, guys, because look at that. That's a cutie. You get to live. Never let go, Jack! Never let go! Never let go, Jack. Never let go.